So students, in our last class we were learning chapter mineral nutrition, that is chapter number 12. We will continue that. In our last class we have discussed criteria for essentiality of minerals. Today we will discuss minerals are of two types based on in what quantity plant requires it. If plant requires minerals in very less quantity, then they are micronutrients. Micro means less, small. Plant requires them in very small quantity, then they are micronutrients. If plant requires them in large quantity, then it is macronutrients. Macro means large or more. Okay, so based on quantitative requirement, meaning in what quantity plant requires, whether it plant requires less or more. If plant requires less, it is micro. If it requires more, then it is macronutrients. Out of that, you can see for neat point of view, what you should know is carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, CHO. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, these three are non-minerals. Then very important is primary nutrients, which is required to the plants, or primary minerals or nutrients, which every plant requires. That is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. In general, we say NPK. If you ask any farmer who doesn't have education also, he knows about nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. That is normally farmers will put in their field. That is primary nutrients every plant requires, that is nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, NPK. Then secondary nutrients are there, that is called secondary macronutrients. NPK are primary macronutrients because plant require NPK in large quantity. Which minerals plant requires other than these three? That is secondary macronutrients. It is called calcium, magnesium, sulfur. If you remember, when we were discussing chapter biomolecules about minerals, chemical coordination and integration, then question was there. They had given three elements name. They asked which elements are required for organisms other than these. That is, NPK was already given, hydrogen was given. We had four choices, where one choice had calcium, magnesium, sulfur. At that time you didn't understand what it is. I told you in other class we will learn. This is that plant require in large quantity after NPK. NPK is compulsory. That's why it is called primary macronutrients, means plant requires in large quantity. Then calcium, magnesium and sulfur are macro only. Plant requires in large quantity after NPK. Secondary importance. First place is NPK, second place is calcium, magnesium, sulfur. So all these are called macronutrients. Which are macronutrients? Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, potash, calcium, magnesium and sulfur. How many are there? 9 are there. What we have learnt in our last class? How many elements are essential for plants? You can see here, it's written. 17 elements are required. These 17 elements are required for all the plants. Okay. Means, all the plant means, every plant doesn't require all 17. But if you consider all the plants around the world, maximum all the plants around the world, all together, it requires 17 elements. But mineral requirement of each plant is different. But NPK is compulsory. Nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium is compulsory. Then calcium, magnesium, sulfur also most of the plant requires. That's why it is called primary and secondary macronutrients. So out of 17, 9 are macronutrients. Means 9 elements plant require in large quantity, which is that carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium and sulfur. These are 9 elements which plant requires in large quantity. Then out of 17, if you remove 9, how many remains? 8. So remaining 8 elements are micronutrients, meaning plant requires them in less quantity. Which are those? You can see here, these are micronutrients, that is boron, B, boron, chlorine, copper, iron, that is Fe, Mn, that is manganese, Mo, that is molybdenum, Si, that is silicon, Na, that is sodium, and Zn is zinc. These are the 8 elements which plant requires in very less quantity, trace amount. But first 9 elements plant require in large quantity. So 9 plus 8, 9 macronutrients, 8 micronutrients. So 9 plus 8, 17 elements are essential for plant growth and development. Okay. Now you see there, I told you macronutrients. These are the macronutrients, what you see. 9 are there: carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, sulfur, potassium, calcium, magnesium. So these are the 9 minerals or elements in the periodic table which plant requires in large quantity, more quantity. In what quantity it requires? You see, they are present in plant tissues in large amounts, like more than 10 millimole per kg of dry matter. Means for every 1 kg, for every 1 kg of the plant material, means for every 1 kg of plant part, 10 millimole of these 9 elements will be there. Okay. So if plant requires more than this quantity, 10 millimole per kg of a plant, then see, plant can be 400 kg, 500 kg, or it will be in tons. Okay. So for every kg, plant requires these 9 minerals in quantity more than 10 millimole per kg. Okay. Then carbon, hydrogen and oxygen are mainly obtained from carbon dioxide and water, you know. Carbon dioxide, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, you know. Carbon is available along with oxygen, that is as carbon dioxide, CO2, C is carbon, you know. And oxygen is available here, O2 is there. Even in water also O is there. So then H2O, water contains H there. So carbon, C, O, H, all three are available in carbon dioxide and water. Then others are absorbed from the soil as mineral nutrients. Okay, how these minerals will enter the plant? Along with water. When water enters the roots of the plant, along with that, minerals also will be dissolved. And minerals are dissolved in water. When plant takes water, along with water, it will take minerals also. So carbon, hydrogen, oxygen is available from carbon dioxide and water. Okay. And the remaining elements plant has to absorb from the soil. Then next slide, if you see. Micronutrients, they are also called trace elements. Why they are called trace element? The word trace means very less quantity. Very less quantity. Okay. So plant requires less than 10 millimole per kg of dry matter of the plant. Means for every 1 kg of the plant part, less than 10 millimole minerals it requires. If plant requires more than 10 millimolar per kg, then it is macro, means large quantity. If plant requires less than this quantity, then it is micronutrients. So what all are micronutrients? You can see on the screen there, that is iron, manganese, copper, molybdenum, zinc, boron, chlorine and nickel. These are all 8 elements which are called micronutrients, which plant requires in less quantity. Then some exception cases are there, you see. For higher plants, means for angiospermic plants, huge trees, only these 17 elements are not enough. Some of the higher plants require 4 extra minerals. So 17 plus 4, 21 elements. But these 4 elements are not compulsory for all the plants. This is optional. But some plants, without these four minerals, it cannot survive. Only 17 are not enough. Which are those? Sodium, silicon, cobalt, and selenium. You see, sodium, silicon, cobalt, and selenium. So, okay, these four are also required for plants. Some plants, not all the plants. Now, essential mineral elements, how they are classified? These 17 elements, how they are classified? They are classified based on their work, what that mineral does in the plant. What work mineral has inside the plant, that will make the classification. Like, for example, components of biomolecules and structural elements of cells. Like, which all minerals out of these 17 what we have studied, which all minerals are present in cell parts, part of the cell membrane, then which forms a biomolecules like proteins, carbohydrates, amino acids, lipids. These are formed by which elements? Simple. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. They form biomolecules, you know. Biomolecules chapter already you have learnt. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen forms carbohydrates, you know. With nitrogen, amino acids, because it contains NH2 group, amino group. NH means hydrogen, you know. COOH group is there, carboxyl group. C is there, O is there, H is there, you can see. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, they form biomolecules and part of the cell membrane. Okay, they are first group. Then second group is components of energy related compounds. Means some elements produce energy containing compounds like ATP. ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So definitely phosphorus is one element which produces ATP, because P stands for phosphorus, you know. So phosphorus is one element which produces energy containing compound, that is one of the classification. Then magnesium present in chlorophyll. Chlorophyll molecule contains magnesium. So magnesium in chlorophyll, which is required for trapping sunlight energy and converting solar energy into chemical energy. Then phosphorus is present in ATP, which also forms energy currency of the cell, that is ATP, which gives energy. And third, elements that activate or inhibit enzymes. Some elements are there out of that 17 elements, essential elements. They will either activate some enzymes or inhibit enzymes. Means these minerals can make enzymes active or they can stop enzyme action. Like, for example, magnesium is activator of Rubisco enzyme. You know what it is. Magnesium is required for Mg2+ is required for activating enzyme Rubisco. You know what is the meaning of Rubisco? Rubisco is enzyme required for C3 and C4 cycle in photosynthesis. You have already learnt it. Rubisco stands for ribulose 1,5 bisphosphate carboxylase oxygenase enzyme, which is required for absorption of atmospheric carbon dioxide during C3 cycle and C4 cycle. Then you know. So then phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase, this is required for C4 cycle peptase. No, phosphoenol pyruvate carboxylase, peptase in short. So Rubisco is required for C3 cycle, peptase is required for C4 cycle. These enzymes will be inactive, but they become active in presence of Mg2+. You already know this. Okay, then the critical enzymes of photosynthetic carbon fixation. Means just now I said it, in photosynthesis, for absorbing carbon dioxide, for fixing carbon it is required. Then fourth category is elements that alter osmotic potential of the cell. Means the elements which alter osmotic potential, means higher potential or lower potential of osmotic fluids is potassium, which is required for opening and closing of stomata. Potassium is required for opening and closing of stomata. That is how it helps the plant. Okay, so these are the four classifications of minerals. Then next, What is the role of macro and micronutrients in plant? Why did we say that these minerals, 17 minerals are essential for the plants? Without these minerals, plant cannot survive. Then what work it does in the plant? Definitely it should play a very important role in the plant. Otherwise we don't say like that, isn't it? So what role it plays in the plant, you can see. Number one, permeability of cell membrane. Means if any molecule should pass through the cell membrane, the plasma membrane, from outside the cell to inside or from inside the cell to outside, if any chemical should pass through the membrane, then it requires these elements. Then second, maintenance of osmotic concentration of cell sap. Cell sap means liquid present in the cell, that is cytoplasm, nucleoplasm, the fluid present in nucleus and cytoplasm. Okay, so osmotic concentration, that is either hypertonic or hypotonic or isotonic solution. Okay, concentration of cell sap is also because of nutrients. Then electron transport systems, you already know. For electron transport system also, for electron transport system also, these are required. Okay, which is a part of photosynthesis and also respiration in plants. Then buffering action. For buffering action also, these minerals are required. Then enzymatic activity. If enzyme should get activated or enzyme should be inhibited, if enzyme should function properly in the plant, then also, like you have seen that Rubisco enzyme and Pepcase enzyme, no? So they get activated by minerals. So definitely for enzymatic activity it is required. That means if enzyme should work in the plant, then these minerals are required. Then they are constituents of macromolecules and coenzymes. Like these minerals are part of macromolecules. Like you know what are macromolecules. So polysaccharides, proteins, all these are macromolecules, you know. So their size is, molecular weight is more than 1000 Daltons. So to form these macromolecules and all the biomolecules, like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, okay, that is lipids, all these amino acids, for forming all these things, that is forming macromolecules like proteins, okay, these are required, minerals are required. Then they also produce coenzymes like coenzyme A, NAD, no? For all these, for producing all this, they are required. Like NAD, name only says, nicotinamide, adenine, dinucleotide, no? Phosphate. So phosphorus is required there, nitrogen is required. So these are very important. Then let us see how each mineral is important to the plant. One by one we will discuss what function every single mineral does in the plant. Okay, first we'll start with nitrogen, because this is the most abundant, which is present in the atmosphere in very large quantity. Okay, so you can see there, they are showing plant and this is a soil. In the soil, nitrogen is present in two forms. One is nitrate, that is NO3-, and other one is ammonium ions, that is NH4+. So plant absorbs nitrogen from the soil in the form of either ammonium ions, that is NH4+, or nitrate, that is NO3-. You can see there, NH4, where N is nitrogen, NO3-, that is N is nitrogen. So plant absorbs nitrogen from the soil in the form of nitrate or ammonium. Now question is, how that nitrate came in soil? Very simple. Nitrogen is present in the atmosphere, which is a gas, you know. 78% nitrogen is there in the atmosphere, 21% oxygen is there, 0.03% carbon dioxide is there, you know. Then 0.097% other gases are there, including argon. So 78% nitrogen in the atmosphere, some bacteria, they are called nitrogen fixing bacteria, present in the soil, will absorb the nitrogen, gaseous nitrogen, and convert it to nitrite and nitrate. In nitrogen cycle, I think you have learnt in high school. Then some plants can directly absorb nitrogen, so that the bacteria present in the soil will absorb nitrogen and convert nitrogen to ammonia and nitrate. so that it is the nitrogen is present in the soil as either nitrate or ammonium ions. What role it plays, important role it plays. So it is required for all the plant, mainly meristematic tissues and metabolically active cells. See, that's why I said nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, these three are considered as primary macronutrients. They are required for all the plants. Nitrogen is required for all the plants. Okay. But they plants require in higher quantity also, large quantity also. Why they are required? Because all the meristematic cells, means actively growing cells, if any new plant part to be produced, like new leaf, anything new should be produced, if cell should divide also, these nitrogen is required. So for meristematic cells, these are required, which is required for cell division, so active growth of plants. And it is a major constituent of amino acids, proteins, nucleic acids, chlorophyll, vitamins and hormones. We already know in biomolecules chapter, we have already learnt that nitrogen is present in amino acids, no? And it is present in proteins. Protein is a long chain of amino acid. Amino word refers to NH3, no? NH2, where N is nitrogen. So nitrogen is there in amino acids, proteins, nucleic acids like DNA and RNA, even in chlorophyll pigment also. Then vitamins are there, vitamins, okay, also contain nitrogen. Hormones also contain nitrogen, like amino acid derivative hormones are there, so hormones also contain. So these are all part of the plant, so nitrogen is definitely required to the plant. Then let us see why phosphorus is required. Phosphorus is plant gets phosphorus from the soil in the form of H2PO4- or HPO42-. H2PO4- or HPO42-. In these two forms, plant will absorb phosphorus from the soil. Okay. So why it is required? Why phosphorus is required? It is a constituent of cell membrane. Like you can see, they are showing plasma membrane structure there. Fluid mosaic model, already you have learnt. Fluid mosaic model given by Singer and Nicholson, two scientists. You have already learnt it. It's a bilipid layer. So it contains proteins, you know, peripheral proteins are there, integral proteins are there in plasma membrane. You have already learnt it. So these contain proteins, then nucleic acids, that is DNA and RNA, and nucleotides. You know what is nucleotide means? Nucleotide means it will have three parts. One is phosphate group, then nitrogen base, that is adenine, guanine, thymine, cytosine, uracil. Then it contains pentose sugar, no, deoxyribose sugar or ribose sugar, that is nucleotide. So nucleotides, proteins and nucleic acids contain phosphorus. So phosphorus is also part of membrane, cell membrane, that is plasma membrane. We have already learned that phospholipids are present there, so phosphate is there, and it is required for phosphorylation reaction. You know what is phosphorylation reaction? That is producing ATP, where ATP, P contains what? Phosphate, no? Adenosine triphosphate, where phosphate is phosphorus. So for producing ATP in the plant also, phosphorus is required. Then potassium, let us see what is the function of potassium in the plant. You can see the leaf, some leaf turns yellowish, no? So that shows that potassium is absent. So potassium is absorbed from the soil in the form of potassium ions, like K plus. Plant absorbs these potassium from the soil in the form of potassium ions, K plus ions. Okay, what is their functions? It is required for meristematic tissues, for flower buds, leaves and root tips. If root tip has to grow, then flower buds should be produced, new leaves should be produced, then if cells should divide, meristematic cells, then they require potassium. That is why I said potassium, NPK, that is potassium, phosphorus and nitrogen, these are NPK, these are primary macronutrients. Every plant requires these in large quantity. No, nitrogen is compulsory for all. Why every plant requires? Because you have seen meristematic cell requires it. Without meristematic cell, plant cannot grow only. Okay, for growth and development of plant, NPK, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium is required. Okay, then very important, what is the function? One function we saw, it is required by meristems, buds, leaves and root tips. Then what work it does? It maintains anion cation balance in the cells, like positive ions and negative ions balance. No, K plus, it is a positive ion, cation. So cation anion balance, that is positive negative ion balance, will be done by potassium. Then potassium is also involved in protein synthesis. If protein should be produced in the plant, then potassium is required. Then you already know this, that K plus potassium is required for opening and closing of stomata. Then potassium is required for activating some enzymes, and it is also required for maintaining turgidity of cells. Turgidity means to have water inside the cells. When cells take up water, or when water enters the cell, the volume of cell increases. That is called turgidity, no? That is cell absorbing water. For turgidity of cells, if cells has to take water, for that process also potassium is required. Then why calcium is required to the plant? And calcium is absorbed by the plant from the soil in the form of calcium ions. Plant absorbs calcium from the soil in the form of calcium ions, that is Ca2+, no, divalent cation Ca2+, and it is required by meristematic and differentiating tissues. See, if any meristematic cell should divide, that is required for growth and differentiating tissues, means one cell changes to other. Like meristematic cell differentiates and becomes parenchyma. Parenchyma differentiates and becomes collenchyma. Collenchyma becomes sclerenchyma. Like that, one after the other, cell will grow and differentiate. For that process also calcium is required. Then it accumulates in older leaves. Old leaves, mature leaves will contain calcium. But when mature leaf dies, just before its death, mature leaf will transfer all its mineral to young leaves. Okay, and it will fall off. This is same like in human beings also. Like old age people, when they are dying, they will transfer all their property to their next generation, like that. What is their function? What is the function of calcium? You already know. Calcium is required for calcium pectate layer, that is for forming new plasma membrane. Okay, you can see there. During cell division, it is required in synthesis of new cell wall, particularly calcium pectate in the middle lamella. Already you have learned this in cell division chapter. Like during cell division, two processes happen. One is karyokinesis, that is division of nucleus, that is prophase, then metaphase, anaphase, telophase. These are nuclear division, nucleus divides. Then entire cell also should divide into two, that is called cytokinesis. No, cyte means cell, C-Y-T-E. Kinesis means division. Cytokinesis means cell division, right? One cell divides into two daughter cells. So for that, for new cell wall formation, calcium is required, because for forming new cell wall, calcium pectate layer should be produced in the middle lamella. What you see there, that black color layer, what you see? Black color layer. Just above that you can see one orange color layer. That orange color layer is calcium pectate layer, that is required for forming new cell wall. Okay, because when cell divides, one part will not have cell wall, so it has to form new cell wall. So that is how it is required. Then it is also required for forming spindle fibers during cell division. You know what are spindle fibers? The thread-like structure produced which will bind to chromosome and it will drag and separate the chromosome. The thread-like structure is spindle fiber. For spindle fiber formation also, calcium is required. Then for normal functioning of cell membrane also, calcium is required. If all the cell membrane should function properly, like plasma membrane should function properly, then calcium is required. Then calcium activates some enzymes and plays important role in metabolism. Okay, calcium will make some enzymes active. Some inactive enzymes are activated by calcium. Then calcium is required for important metabolism of the plant also. Metabolism of plants also, it is required. Then next, you will see, next slide. Magnesium, why it is required? Plant absorbs magnesium from the soil in the form of magnesium ions, that is Mg2+. Why it is required? You see, if magnesium is low, if less magnesium is there in the plant, then leaf will turn yellowish. Okay, leaf will be greenish only when magnesium is more. Means for normal functioning. It activates enzymes of respiration and photosynthesis. Means what all enzymes are required for respiration and photosynthesis, that will be activated by magnesium. We already know, like, what is that? Electron transport system in respiration in plants. Then glycolysis steps in respiration. It requires, glycolysis requires 10 enzymes because 10 steps are there. Each step requires enzyme. All that enzymes will be activated by magnesium. Then you already know pyruvate dehydrogenase enzyme is required during Krebs cycle. That also is activated by Mg2+ only. So magnesium is required for activating enzymes which is required for respiration in plants and photosynthesis in plants. Then magnesium is also involved in synthesis of DNA and RNA. For producing DNA and RNA, which is a nucleic acid also, magnesium is required. Then it is a constituent of ring structure of chlorophyll. You can see chlorophyll structure here. In the chlorophyll structure, you can see in the center there is magnesium Mg. Now this is an entire chlorophyll structure, which is a green pigment which gives green color to plant parts, especially leaves. The chlorophyll pigment also, if you see the chemical structure there, in the center there is Mg, that is magnesium. So magnesium is required for producing chlorophyll pigment, and it also helps for ribosome structure. We know this. For ribosomes, which is called protein factories of the cell, if ribosome should maintain its shape for normal functioning of ribosomes, also magnesium is required. Okay, so this is some minerals we have learnt. In next class we will learn some more minerals. Okay, so keep watching my classes. Thank you.